Welcome to Great Hymns of the Faith. My name is John Fraser. I'm your host. It is great to have you with us today, folks. We welcome you. Whether it's Sunday morning you're listening to this or any morning throughout the week, could be in the afternoon, maybe the evening. Some of you I know are even listening to this program during the dark hours of the night. Whatever it might be, wherever you are, we're glad to have you with us. Now, let me tell you about our first hymn. The author is Edward Perronet. His dates are 1726 to 1792. He was the son of an Anglican minister. His family, by the way, descended from French Huguenots who fled the continent to escape religious persecution. And for a time, he was a co-worker of John and Charles Wesley. What's Perronet's hymn that I want to share with you today? Well, it's called All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name.
All hail the power of Jesus' name, let angels prostrate fall. Bring forth the
The author of this hymn is a man who loved the outdoors. He loved to hike. He enjoyed nature. And often, before setting out on a hike, he would say to those that he left behind, "I'm going out to see my Father's world." His name is Maltby D. Babcock, and the hymn that he authored is called, "This Is My Father's World."
This is my Father's world, and to my listening ears, all nature sings and round me rings the music of the spheres. This
Listen to this verse from Holy Scripture. I will behold thy face in righteousness. I shall be satisfied when I awake with thy likeness. That's Psalm 17, verse 15. And perhaps Carrie E. Breck had this verse in mind when she composed the words to the hymn called Face to Face with Christ My Savior.
My Savior, face to face, what will it be? When with rapture I behold Him, Jesus Christ, who died for me. Face to face I shall behold.
Many of the hymns that we sing have their basis in Scripture. That's why it's so important whenever you sing a hymn that you look at the words. What are the words saying? Because you know what's happening today, folks? We have many hymns that really don't have their basis in Scripture. And you will often find that they're singing about themselves. It's what I call the me, me, me hymns, when we should be singing about the greatness of God. Listen to these two verses from Jeremiah chapter 10, verses 6 and 7. The author writes, "There is none like you, O Lord. You are great, and your name is great in might. Who would not fear you, O King of the nations? For this is your due. For among all the wise ones of the nations, and in all their kingdoms, there is none like you." Our next hymn is called Great is Jehovah, and it's sung by the late Kenneth McKellar. Thank you. Featherstone, 1846 to 1873. He was from Montreal, Quebec, Canada. He was a member of the Wesleyan Methodist Church in Montreal. Later, it was renamed to St. James Methodist Church, and then still later, St. James United Church. William Featherstone was only 16. Imagine that, folks. He was 16 years old when he composed the words to the hymn, My Jesus, I Love Thee.
My Jesus, I love thee, I know thou art mine. For thee all the follies of sin I resign. My Savior art thou.
Philippians 4, verse 4 reads, "Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice." Well, I've mentioned the name of the author of this hymn that I want to share with you. I've mentioned his name earlier in the program. It was Charles Wesley. And his dates, by the way, those of you who keep dates of the authors who composed the various hymns, his dates were 1707 to 1788, and the hymn that he composed is called Rejoice, the Lord is King. The year was 1538. The name was Sarum Primer, and he composed the words to the hymn, God Be in My Head. That's right, God be in my head, not God be in my heart. Think about that for a moment. 1 Kings chapter 8, verse 57 reads, God be with us. And we know he is. Because Jesus said, I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. And that thought is always going to be in our head, as well as our heart. Enjoy the hymn. Katharina A. von Schlegel, in the year 1752, composed the words to the hymn called Be Still My Soul. It was translated from German to English by Jane L. Borthwick in 1855, perhaps based on the Psalm 46, verse 10, Be still and know that I am God. Now, I know I've shared this with you before, but it bears repeating. This hymn, Be Still My Soul, was a favorite of Eric Little, the athlete who became famous in the 1924 Olympics for refusing to run on the Sabbath. Remember the film Chariots of Fire? That came out in 1981. Little later became a missionary in China, and he was in prison during World War II. He is said to have taught this hymn to others in the prison camp, where he eventually died of a brain tumor. Be still, my soul. I'm afraid that's all the time that we have for today, but it was great to have you with us, and I trust, as always, that the good Lord willing, that you will be able to join us next week as well for more of Great Hymns of the Faith. Until then, God bless.